friends. For our last steam, I decided it would be fun to make our favorite cookies. It can be your favorite holiday cookie, and if you are not a holiday celebrator, that is absolutely fine. I think everybody has a favorite cookie, whether it's holidays or not. I will be making my favorite cookie bar called 7-Layer Magic Bars. I'll be modifying the recipe a little bit. And what I'm hoping we'll do is that you guys will make your cookies and then post your recipe on the stream so that we all can possibly make your cookies and find a new favorite cookie recipe. So I have my butter melting. Now I am allergic to gluten, wheat. So I have to make modifications. And this year, instead of using the traditional graham cracker crust, I'm gonna try cornflakes and see how those turn out. It could be a disaster, it could be delicious. So let's check how my butter's doing. Butter's good. All right, so I'm gonna measure in a cup and a half. What I love about this recipe is ish is good enough. So a cup and a half of graham cracker crumbs. You can use pretzel crumbs. I've used those. Very delicious. I'm trying this year with cornflakes because why not? It's 2020 and nothing makes sense anyway. Alright, then you mix your crumbs with your butter. I have prepared a 9x13 pan. And by prepared, that means you sort of smear some oil or butter or ghee at the bottom just to help things not stick. Good enough is good enough. I'm going to take my spatula and just sort of spread this out. No obligation to make these cookies. Truthfully, you're under no obligation to watch this video either. You guys know how to make your own cookies. I'm just doing it in case you want to make 7-layer magic bars along with me. Be sure your hands are clean. Nobody wants schmutz in their 7-layer bars. All right, there we go. Good enough is good enough. So then, this is how I do it. Now, I layer things differently than they do. So they ask for a cup and a third of flaked coconut. And I put that at the bottom because that's how I like it and it's my recipe. They're my cookie bars and I'm really the only one who eats them. So, smear that around. Grab a third. Add that too. And add a little bit more for good measure. Because why not? It's 2020 and nothing makes sense anyway. So you may as well make some cookies and bring a little joy into your mouth. All right, then the next ingredients are, oops, forgot to open the bag. Butterscotch morsels. Everybody says chips, but admit it, morsels is more fun to say. Now, I have done other kinds of magic 7-layer bars, if butterscotch isn't your thing. I have also used white chocolate chips and dried cranberries with rousing success. They are absolutely delicious. So don't be afraid to reach outside of the 7-layer magic bars. And I'm going to take a cup of semi-sweet morsels. And I shall sprinkle those all over. If it doesn't look like enough, you are always welcome to add a skosh more, because it's 2020 and nothing makes sense anyway. And it's yours. You can make them however you like. Then you take a cup of chopped nuts if you want or not. Again, you can use dried fruit, or you can skip it all together and put in a different kind of chip. Morsel. You can add white chocolate. You can probably add brickle or Heath bar bits. Add all kinds of stuff. Then, the piece de resistance that brings everything together is sweetened condensed milk. The recipe calls for you to push the crust, pour it over the crust and push everything into it. I can't be bothered with that, and I love the sticky of the sweetened condensed milk, so I pour it along the top and let it soak down as it bakes. The heat will pull the sweetened condensed milk to the bottom and everything becomes sticky. It's a very sticky bar if you've never had them before. And I want every ounce of sweetened condensed milk. I don't spread it or anything. I just leave it exactly as it is. Then these will go in the oven for about 25-30 minutes at 350. And then I let them cool and they'll be ready for snacking. Have fun baking cookies, and I can't wait to see your recipes.